please join me in welcoming to Fresh Out Live Infinity Song. Hello, give me some pounds. I don't wanna give too many hugs out. I don't wanna hug. Infinity Song. Standing position, right? Y'all got, okay, y'all in the spots, okay. Whoa, I like that deep voice. I love it. Let's jump right into it, okay? We're gonna start from the beginning. Your siblings, you love music.
Yeah.
But how did you form a band?
Let's see. We've been singing together since we were toddlers. I've been singing since I was five. All of us started really young, our parents. We're educators. Our dad was a choir director, so music is our way of life, and it's our safe place. So,
is he still directing y'all now? Choir directors. You know, that's a different level of direction. We got to talk about your latest project, Metamorphosis. It's out right now, and it features songs like Haters Anthem as well as Slow Burn. Now, the title itself implies a sense of transformation. Can you describe to me what that project's all about?
It's really about going deep within yourself and being patient with yourself, going through a cocoon moment, whatever you're going through in life. And it's really about going from not liking yourself to loving yourself. So if you can relate to that,
okay.
It's a journey.
It's a journey. We gotta talk about the record that everybody's wanting. They're loving it and they aren't hating on it. And I'm talking about that Haters Anthem. Tell me about this record.
Well, Haters Anthem is really supposed to be a tool to look within. I think a lot of us, we have moments where we've been not so loving, and you know, there's social media, you're constantly comparing and contrasting your life with others, and you can sometimes go down a spiral of just, you know, nasty emotions, but it's human, you know, it's real. So I think, you know, this song was just addressing it, bringing it out into the light so that we can all work on it together.
I like that. Inclusiveness.
Yeah. It's the metamorphosis.
I love that. Now, you talked about singing since you were a toddler and having those deep family roots, but professionally, how were you discovered? And tell me about your relationship with the iconic New York rapper, Jay-Z.
it was like 2015 or 16.
16?
And he had seen a video of our sister performing. Our sister performs as well. And he's like, oh, I want to meet her. And we kind of are like, oh, we're going to tag along. Of course, actually our dad was like, you guys are going to tag along. And we're like, yeah. And you're going to come meet Jay-Z. And it was kind of much like this, where we went to the office and we performed just with the guitar and us singing. And it was much like this. He brought the office out and we performed for him and the whole Roc Nation office. And it was amazing. And then we got signed.
Yeah, it was just... It was like a Cinderella moment. It was a special moment that we'll never forget. So
don't forget it. Congratulations in advance. We got the tour jumping off next week.
Yeah.
Tell me about that experience. What can we look forward to?
New York can look forward to the Blue Note on April 15th through 18th coming up.
Yes.
And that's gonna be amazing shows. Yeah. And then we're going to Europe in May and June, and that's our first time overseas performing on tour. It's gonna be amazing. Give the best shows we've ever given.
Yeah.
Also, Lollapalooza, that's gonna be
We're on Lollapalooza.
Lollapalooza.
This is huge, okay.